Courtney, I'm going to be the moderator this afternoon. We have three speakers talking about how to communicate to your audience. And first, I'm going to introduce Marta Keen. She's the Illinois Recycling Association President and a recycling specialist for Will County. And she's going to talk about marketing the sustainability message. And then we have two other speakers coming, and I'll give a present introduction when they come up. But if we could leave our questions for the end, I would appreciate it. And we're also being filmed today, so just so you know, we're going to be filming this session. And we'll have Marta. Thank you.
Just so you know, the reason that this is being filmed is we're doing a presentation for iGen. We have a sustainability course starting. And this is actually going to serve two purposes. I'm going to be running through it today as an intro to what we're hoping will be a really great session on how to market your message, how to package it, different ways you can approach the messaging that you're doing. But then this is really just kind of like a marketing 101. What are all the different options that you have available to you? So my bio is on here for purposes of iGen. Believe me, you don't need to know it all. So green messaging 101, marketing is obviously very important. You have multiple approaches that you can use in order to reach different groups of people. You have to consider things like cost, time, and actually the impact of the word choices that you make. There are low-tech and high-tech ways to get your message out there. So identifying and tailoring your message and figuring out who your audience is very important. In talking with businesses, trying to get businesses to recycle, a lot of times it comes down to your communication with custodial staff, as an example. So you're looking at what are their needs, what do they need to know? And one of the first things that I've found when you're putting up signs is, and we made this mistake in our own office, having a sign that's in English and Spanish, and our cleaning folks were bullish. So again, knowing your audience is actually very important, and it's very helpful. And even translating words can sometimes be difficult, so making that very clear. Also, the use of graphics, because again, language barrier, but also speed. Let's think about this. You know, we're all in the tech age. How fast do we read things? So how fast do we read a sign? And you want the picture to help you understand the story, that wonderful old adage of pictures worth a thousand words. That's what you want with anything you're developing for your marketing. Keeping it simple. Communicating things quickly, easily, very, very important. So that's really communicating with your audience. Other audience members might be your suppliers. And a lot of times you'll hear this as you're trying to figure out how to reduce the packaging stream that's coming to you. Yes, you can recycle it. And sometimes that recycling can actually give you some money. Maybe you get paid for your cardboard bales. But other times, the packaging is still representing time. You have to use a baler. You have to find somebody to pick it up. You have to have a lot of staff dedicated to that. If you just reduce that, to be honest, like, then maybe you can reduce your costs. So you have to go up to your suppliers and say, what can we do about this? And bring that supply chain. You need to have conversations with those folks, and you need to look at your bid documents when you do this. What are you putting into those bid documents? I know, working for the government as I do, we require three copies of your bid on paper, okay? And most people who give us a bid will put it single-sided. So, you know, I walk in and go, I want it electronically, I want it double-sided, you have to have a printed piece, I want it on recycled content paper, and my purchasing person goes, what? after her head stops spinning, we try and find some mutual common ground. But we have made some progress, but then making that happen across the board. That might work for me, because that's what I'll require, but will work for other departments in the same company, and spreading that out there. So talking to your purchasing folks to help them get you on board with your suppliers is very important. Looking at other potential suppliers, this has been very successful for some large purchasing, and I know that this worked for me years ago when I was in the private sector. We had a paper supplier who at the time, and I know I'm dating myself at this point. This is pre-1992, which is when I went into the government side of things. But we had a supplier for our paper, and that supplier did not have recycled content paper. So what we basically did was we went to them and said, you know what, next time we bid, we are going to say we need to have 10% recycled content. It was amazing how by the time that we bid the next time after that, our old paper supplier suddenly had recycled content paper. So you make a significant impact, and people do not want to lose your business. You need to take advantage of those things. And then the other side of it is you need to be open to their suggestions. If you say we want electronic billing, they say we want electronic payments, maybe you need to make some adjustments. So that happens. It saves you both money. Okay? So that kind of thing, and resources. Another message that you send out will be to coworkers. Okay, so again, I told you my story with purchasing already, but one of the really big advocates that you might find is your accounting office. If you can find the right person, somebody who loves crunching numbers, and you can get them to sit there and look at cost savings. No, we saved all those pieces of paper that were only used on one side, and we sent that over to the print shop, and they cut it up and used it as scrap paper. We wouldn't have to buy any more notepads for people. Well, how much would that save? Now, I can tell you from my experience right now on the government side, they went to our auditor. And we said, you know, our electricity bills are costing a lot of money, but not all the departments are really into getting the employees to go down to one printer and one copier. They all like to have their little individuals, their cubicles. You know, they don't always turn out their lights. You know, it's great when we mention it at a green meeting, but we really just don't have a lot of say over that. And all of a sudden, our auditor let me know, I've been crunching numbers, and that can save us a lot of money. So I'm going to go in, and I'm going to talk to them. We'll do random audits of their department, see how they're doing, you know, give them a scorecard. So we haven't implemented it yet, but we got them on board, and we're really excited about that. That's something, but you got to find the right mindset. You got to have somebody who's there in the trenches with you, willing to look at all these possibilities. And then, it's not just you preaching this word. Now, all of a sudden, you're seeing all the financial rewards and getting that word out to other people who might get rewarded. Maybe they'll even get a better budget because they save money in one place, spend it somewhere else. The other thing, of course, is that challenge of all the folks that you run into who tell you how you can't possibly do this. And they give you one excuse after the other. Why can't you keep throwing suggestions at them and ways to overcome that? And they're still telling you why you can't do it. And you know what? Having those other advocates in there, going around, talking to people, and actually really trying to make that effort to learn what really they're encountering as problems. Maybe it's not your suggestion. Maybe they've got some other headaches. And you're just one more. So maybe you try to figure out there's a way you can be less of a headache and more of a good bonus thing for them if you can get them on board. But also, don't rule out going to management and saying, we need a rule, we need a procedure, this needs to be the way we do things. Because that's also something else you can have in the arsenal. Communicating with coworkers also is just what you do personally to get your word out to your coworkers. So writing a memo or having, you know, a memo you write up and have somebody higher up that you sign that makes it way more official than coming from you is always a great thing to do. Having emails. I've done various approaches to this. For April, I would do an email every day on a new tip. Short, sweet, to the point. You will irritate some fellow employees. They will ban you from sending them emails. They will tell you to drop me from your list, you know, and I have great excuses for that. You know, I'm just hitting the, you know, send all. I can't sit here and type every employee's name in. So yeah, just delete it if you really don't want to read it. So they still get it. And if you can put that subject line, what you really want to try to get across, in one line in the subject, before they hit the delete button, they might actually hit the point. So those things. Putting it on a bulletin board, always a great thing, you know, putting it there in the cafeteria, putting it there with the job postings, putting it someplace somebody's going to read it. And, you know, please, report your progress on these things, because that's positive. So if you know last year you recycled, you know, 10% of your waste, and this year you're 15% of your waste, show a graph, show how you're doing, okay, how much money you save. Whatever it is that you think is a positive message for people to see, it's great to get that out on there. Maybe you'll even start some water cooler talk. posters, that's my word on posters. Okay, I don't know if you've ever seen them in an elevator, but we're struggling with new territory right now. What about the lavatory? What the heck? Put it there. People aren't doing anything else. Look at that. Okay? So make it light, make it funny, change it frequently. Okay? Don't take it too seriously. But yeah, some posters that you can put around promoting whatever it is that you think is important. And if it helps to brainstorm a few different things, they have them already. And then maybe once a month you run around and you change them in all the places that you have them up. And then that measuring and sharing the results. And sharing them graphically. I love going into schools. One of my favorite places is going into schools. Instead of one of those boring charts that shows growth or whatever, you have somebody showing how much got recycled of paper in the growth of a tree. So here's that tree, and it's colored in to show how much of the tree you grew by how many tons of paper you recycled. Awesome. Okay? I love that. And now it gets your attention. So don't rely on just all the business stuff you might see out there. Go into a school program and see all the ways there, let the kids know what a great job they're doing with their recycling. And then your residents. Okay, I always think they are their most challenging group, and they've become more challenging. As I mentioned, I started this in 1992 on the public sector side, trying to get information out there to the entire community. And back then, there were a few newspapers that were commonly read. And back then, there was the Thursday night lineup. Everybody did. Friends was going to be on Thursday, and Seinfeld and all the rest of them for any of you my age. Okay, but nowadays, that's all changed. So nowadays, the most watched single event on television that you'll have the most people talking about across the country is the Super Bowl. We all know we can't afford to advertise there. So, bottom line, you need to diversify your message to really get it out to the public. You need to remember that there is a rule of seven times. And you might think, well, you know, I've got this. I told them I was having a drop-off. Why didn't people show up? Okay? Well, how many ways did you tell them? How many times did they see it in all those different ways that you told them? And that's really important. Social media is awesome. But I can tell you right now, just because social media is out there doesn't mean everybody's reading your post, okay? Facebook, they're now saying, and I don't know if this is true, judging from my own children, I would say Facebook's just as popular as ever. But they're saying on the national level that Facebook is going down and Tumblr's coming up. I have not even been on Tumblr yet. I just got the Pinterest. Which my daughter corrected me and said, Mom, it's not Pinterest. Anybody know? Pinterest? There you go. So I'm corrected. And, I think I have two things pinned. But it's, you know, this is a fast-moving medium. We at Illinois Recycling Association, we have YouTube, we have Twitter, we have Facebook, and we have LinkedIn. And I can tell you, to promote this conference, we were using all but the YouTube. We didn't use the YouTube. And just today alone, I know that one of my other board members and I have been shooting posts out to Facebook like crazy. Does it mean I got more attendance? No, we're doing pretty average. It's a good year. It's not a bad year. It's an average year. So for all that effort, I can't say that we can prove that that made a huge impact. Will it make an impact down the line? Did I reach some people who've never heard of us before because their friends reposted? Maybe, I don't know. You've got that whole viral effect. But it's another way to get your word out. It's really important to continue to